Hello guys, my name is Mukanya. I'm a CEO and founder at JT Devs. Welcome back on another video on object-oriented programming in JavaScript. So we're going to start by defining a class. A class is a blueprint or a plan of a thing. So let's say for instance, you want to build a house. So you must have a plan, yeah? So that plan is indeed a class. So on that particular plan, you're going to specify how many room, garage, or garden you're going to have. And then those items that you specify on the plan, that is the thing that you're going to stick with. So the actual house, that will be your object. So let's define or describe what is an object. An object, it will be a feature that summarizes all the members of a class into one unit. All right, so let's create a class. So to start creating a class in JavaScript, so we need to start with the keyword class and then the class name. Then within a class, we have a constructor. So this guy will allow us to create an object. So with object-oriented programming, if you don't have a constructor, you don't have to worry about that because any program language that is object-oriented, it's going to create a constructor for you if you don't have it. Okay, so let's start creating our attributes. So the attribute will be maybe the eye color if since we want to create a person, but I'm going to stick with the simple features. And then if you have any question, please mention it on the comments and then I'll get back to you. So let's see, and then I'm going to specify this one to be attribute. We're using a this keyword because this keyword is kind of an object, so it's going to allow us to create an attribute and then also allow us to access any feature of a class or members of a class. And we'll say this first name equals to letter this dot surname equals to Mike. Okay, and then that's it. We're done with attribute. We're going to create now method. I'm just going to say methods. So for a method, we're just going to specify the method name. I'm going to select the name of display details. So in here, we're going to display our person information. So I'm going to display full name. Let's say full name dot concat. Then we have this dot first name, comma, we need a space. Now the last one would be this dot surname. All right, and then that's it. So this is going to be the plan. This is our plan. So our plan is to have our attribute and then to display those informations. All right, so now let's create an object. So we're going to start with a letter. Then we say the object name. I'm going to use lowercase p, which will be person one. And then we need to make use of a new keyword because if we don't, then we're going to end up with an error. Then the class name, then that's it. So the new keyword we'll call the constructor at the background. So if you don't have a constructor, it's since it's one of the object-oriented programming, it's going to create one for you. So now let's access a method. So to access a method from a class, we need to access it via the object name. Then we say object name, then the method name. Okay, that's it. Don't forget to make use to specify the parentheses. So the parentheses is just to say that this is going to be a method. So it's very important to specify it, to include it as well. So I'm going to check our code now. Then let's refresh it and voila. And then we also say something that if we have our attributes, we can use those attributes since it's a public. And then, all right, so I think I didn't mention public, mentioned it on the other video. So public is by default, all the members of a class is going to be public. Like this one is going to be a public method. Okay, public attributes. And then since it's a public, then anyone outside of a class can access that particular attribute. Then I will do this person1.firstname. So we need to display it somewhere. Need to display it on the console.doc. Okay, this time I'm going to use documents.write. Documents. What am I doing? .write. Then let's have a look. So it should be displayed on the document. I can close this one. Yeah, here we go. I hope you can see it. Let me just zoom in and here we go. Okay. Then if the member of a class is private, and if you want to make it private, I believe you can use the hashtag before that particular feature. Then I use the hashtag. So the hashtag will make it private, so no one can access it outside of a class. Let me refresh this one here. Okay, let's see, you see. See that it's private. Okay, let's be declare and close class. So if something is a private, we need to use it within a class. We cannot use it outside of a class. Okay. So to create something, even on the method, you can also create use hashtag. That is not a problem. It's still going to make it private. So if you don't have hashtag, then JavaScript we know that you're using public, because that would be by default. What else should I include? So I think we're going to call it a day. Thank you guys. Please subscribe, share, and like the video. Bye.